Hey there. This portion of the video is not shot with the HiDef camera. This is just my little Sony Zacti. But I've uploaded a few other video tests slash reviews, and I get a lot of comments and questions asking me how I like the camera. I have not bought this camera. Okay, I think I'm about to edit the video for the JVC HD-SD100. I had to find a video codec converter that would convert it from the .mts files over to something that I can use in Sony Vegas, which I use. Now, the Sony HiDef camera and the Canon, the HF10, the Sony and the Canon HiDef cameras, those work just fine. Those are .mts files, just like the Panasonic is, but I don't know what the deal is. I'm not that much of an audio or a video file or video file to know the difference between the inner workings of the file formats themselves. So anyway, so I got it busted over to a DivX file, and it's going to be edited, and I'm going to upload it. Anyway, the camera was pretty nice. It's really, really lightweight. It's hard to tell. I shot everything indoors. I was at a local store that sells furniture, appliances, electronics, everything, TVs, everything like that. So it's a lot of fluorescent lights. I think they're fluorescent. I couldn't move around really because the thing is tethered to the place where they display the cameras. But it was nice. It's an attractive camera. It was really, really small. I think, yeah, I mean, this is the review or the test of the HD-SD100. It has 16, no, that's the Canon. This guy only shoots to and records to the SD card, which I put in there and took home. Now, there was no problem as far as putting the card in. It just recognized it. It was already formatted. I had it in a different camera and then put it in this one, and there was no problem there. It just added to the file, to the file structure, to the folder structure, and put the files in there. Now, I have the original MTS files, so if you're watching this and you want to play with them, I can send you the original files. If it gets out of hand and there's a million requests for them, you know, we'll have to see about that, but I can always use some sort of service on the web to upload a clip. I think some of them are, I think I have them here, 17 megs. I have some that are a little bit longer. I tried to vary the clips. Here's a tip for you. If you're out there checking out a HiDef camera and you put your own chip in there, make sure that when you're shooting around, turn it around on yourself and get some video of yourself like 10 seconds, and then do a shoot for about 30 seconds, and then just get some 6 and 7, maybe an additional 10 second clips, because you want those little ones and you want big ones, so you can really get a feel of how the file sizes turn out for the length of time. I find that helpful. That way, then when you're messing around with it like I have been, you can, if you do have to convert the, give me a mental moment here. Yeah, I've got a 162 megabyte file and a 27 megabyte file. And if anyone's really interested, I'd be happy to send them up to Dropload or something like that, where it sends you a link and then you can download from there. Yeah, have those different file sizes so that when you're, if you do have to convert them, you're not converting a 162 meg file, which takes a while, and then you play with it and you find out it doesn't work. Or I found one called MPEG Stream Clip. It's pretty nice, but it has a jillion different options, and it took me probably 15 to 20 tries before I got the right codec, the right settings, the right check boxes, where it would fill up the whole 16:9 preview in Sony Vegas, and I could set it to 720p. Anyway, I'm rambling on and on. But anyway, the main point of this is I did not buy this camera. It's sitting at Nebraska Furniture Mart. I didn't buy it. It's about $700. But most places are pretty nice if you bring in your own SD card, or if it's a Sony, you got to bring in the Sony Memory Pro Duo memory stick and stick it in there. And if video away and take your card out and go home and play with it. It's kind of funny, you can do that, but yet you can't bring in a video camera and video. Whatever. Thanks for watching. Bye.
Okay, this is the Panasonic HD-SD100. It's a card-only camera. It's got the Leica lens on front, HiDef. Now this has a 3 CMOS lens, so I'm really expecting a lot out of the quality on this. On the back end, it's got HDMI out as well as a USB port out. Up on the very front of the camera, it has an 1/8-inch microphone input jack, and underneath the LCD well, there's component out and audio video out, AV out, with a headphone jack. It couples as a headphone jack as well. The menu button is underneath the LCD, as well as an inset joystick, much like on a PSP, but flat. The camera is really, really light, exactly like the Canon FS100. There's almost nothing to it, a lot lighter than the Sony SDR. It's got a flash on the front, and the lens cover automatically opens when you go into record mode. The screen is kind of small and pretty plain, not as high def looking as the Sony. But overall, it's pretty nice looking.